ان شاء الله مسلمين دان مسلماء ينساهر ماس كليان كتا سدان لاجي بواق سورة البقرة دان الحمد لله كتا سنباي كأياء سراتوس سبولو الحمد لله مسلمين دان مسلماء ينساهر ماس كليان we already agreed that we divide the first juzu to many division one is jenis manusia منافق كافر مؤمن another is the story of Adam Hawa and they came down to the earth beginning of the creation and the third part started about Bani Israel Bani Israel from ayat 40 sampai ayat 122 which we are going to finish today in ayat 122 habis cerita Bani Israel and then we are going to do today cerita the good story because Bani Israel is bad example maghdub alayhi today we are going to do an'amta alayhi cerita Nabi Ibrahim he is one of those yeah an'amta alayhi because as I told you البقرة جوابا الفاتحة وين البقرة وسي وات اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم إن البقرة أنعمت عليهم إبراهيم غير المغضوب عليهم يهودي أوكي ولا الضالين آل عمران So you know this is more than enough. We are Malayu. We cannot know ayat, dimi ayat. So this is your asas. Al-Baqarah, jawaban al-Fatiha. One bar. غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ Bani Israel. And why Allah angry with them? They are very bad. We know already many of their scandals. Which we are going to finish it today. And then an'amta alayhim is Nabi Ibrahim and we are going to know his story today. Okay? But just to make you focus, while you are reading Hatti Hadir, you can even guess. You hear Nama Ibrahim, this is the one Allah loves. You hear Ya Bani Israel, these are the people because they never bil shukur, inkar ni'mat Allah. Okay? So, today we are still did not finish yet Shereta Bani Israel because it will be finished at 122. But kita ni baru 111. Okay? We're still talking about that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, of course, just to gustan sikit to continue. Allah said, وَدَّ كَثِيرٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَوْ يَرُدُّونَكُمْ مِّنْ بَعْدِ إِيمَانِكُمْ كُفَّارًا أهل الكتاب نيكا لو بليه they want you to be كافر Why? حَسَدًا مِّنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِهِمْ آيَةَ 109 They are dinky with us So because of that they always كَلَوْ بُلِيه نَأْسُرُ كِتَ جَدِي كَافِرْ شُرُبْ بَدِيَا حَسَدًا the problem between us and Ahlul Kitab, dinky. That's why also one of the sifat mazmuma, min yakib batil, yeah, we Muslims cannot be terlibat if you have dinky. Tambah pula, dinky terhadap Muslim like you. Dinky. Cannot hear someone better than you, cannot hear someone richer than you, cannot hear someone, you know, more beautiful than you, have more jewelry than you. Dinki is this sifat maghdub alayhi. So these people, Allah, sifat mereka is what? Hasadan min indis. They are dinki with Quran Islam. They are ahli kitab. And dinki sudah dosa. Apalagi kalau Muslim sama Muslim. Lagi dosa. Okay. And then Allah said what? Why? من بعد ما تبين لهم الحق. They know the حق. They know kebenaran. They know very well that we are right, they are wrong. Because nama Nabi Muhammad SAW is in their Torah. Muhammad akan datang, he is the last, he is the best. But they incur all that. So they are dinky. So Allah said, because of this, for the time being, fa'fu wasfahu hatta ya'ti Allah bi amri. Wa ta'tahu, maaf-maafan mereka, sampai I give the order. Order what? To kill them kau, to dismiss them from Medina kau. That time Allah said, just leave it as it is till I tell you what to do. Because later, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam have a war with them, dismiss them from Medina, from Mecca. They cannot enter sampai today. So that time Allah said what? A'fu wasfahu. Just ma'af ma'afan dulu, wait till I tell you what to do. That time. Okay? Inna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allah maha berkuasa atas segala-galanya. And then Allah advise, what are the things that can make you suffer with people hasad like this? People, you are facing, you know, living with people hasad you, dinky with you, trying to destroy you. So there is ubat always. Abriya, wa aqimu salata wa atu zakah. Sila salah banyak-banyak. Bersadaqah banyak-banyak. Bayur zakat. All these are the best ubat for the heart. And when you are facing problem like this, people around you, in your office, in your work, in your neighborhood, so much dinky and you don't know what to do, there is a good ubat, salah, sadaqah. You know, we learn from the Quran. Because you know, you see they are opposing Muslims every corner and trying to do khiyana. So Allah said, there is a way to make you calm. Pray, pay zakat, and then, وَمَا تُخَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Anything you do good, you will find it waiting with Allah. Be bersadaqah, be a prayer type, be a nice to people. Because whatever it is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? Anything good you do, you will find it waiting for you, the akhirah nanti. Don't regret about anything good you are doing. Very good ayat. وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ تَجِدْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Always Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muslimin dan Muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian, whenever he want to collect sadaqah, collect derma, he will take his kubiya, go round and say this ayat. وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Anything you do in this dunya good, you will find it waiting for you with Allah. Beautiful ayat. وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Allah maha melihat yang kamu buat. Never regret of things good you do. Never say, if I know, I will not do that to her. I help her to kadiya susah. But she is never grateful to me, no. Because you are doing it for Allah. If you regret, you cancel what you have done. So don't regret. If you do something good, and your nawaitu is for Allah, dia buat jahat kita, dia khianat kita, never mind. Because you think waiting for me there. In my book, never regret. Never say, if I know that, I will never help so and so. If I know that, I will never give what any. No. Because Allah said, anything you do, semata-mata kerana Allah, is waiting for you there. It's in your book already, Masuda. Wallahu bima ta'amaluna basir. I maha melihat what you did, so don't worry. is registered already. Okay. Malika Yahudi the Nasrani, Allah said, وَقَالُوا لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. Mereka ni duduk buat fatwa sendiri. Orang Islam tak masuk syurga. Only Yahudi Nasrani masuk syurga. Allah jawab, تِلْكَ أَمَانِيُّهُمْ. It's only their haraban. It's only their khayal. قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Show me the proof. You have a proof in your book, in your Torah, in your Bible, that only Yahudi Nasrani masuk syurga. From where you bring this fatwa? Anyhow, siapa yang akan masuk syurga sebenarnya? Whether you are Yahudi ka, or you are Nasrani ka, or you are Muslim ka, if bala man aslama wajhahu lillahi wa huwa muhsinun falahu ajruhu inda rabbihi wala khawfun alaihim wala hum yahzanun. Orang yang masuk syurga siapa? Aslama wajhahu lillahi, serah diri kepada Allah, submit yourself to God, and this is Islam. I am humble Allah, He is the creator, I submit myself to Him. That is the meaning of Muslim. من أسلم وجهه لله, and then وهو محسن. عملان عملان dia عملان yang terbaik. Baik dengan manusia, baik dengan Allah. Ikhlas with Allah, baik dengan manusia. Itu syarat-syarat amalan, amalan yang mustajab. How to make your amalan accepted by Allah? Number one, you are doing for Allah. The nawaitu, ikhlas. Number two, you are redoing the best, something from the Quran and the Sunnah. And this is rukun any amalan to be accepted. Any amalan you do, you want it to be accepted, you have to have these two rukun. Number one, ikhlas. I give her material not to please her. It's for sake of Allah. Then your material you give to the people is already registered as sadaqah, as balasan from Allah. But if you give because I want to please her, I want her to love me, I want her to be close to me, I want to ask her help, tomorrow iso she can help me, maybe it's not registered in your book. It has to be aslama wajhahu lillah. That is what we say to Jublas Kalisari, inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. So whatever you do, aslama wajhahu lillah. I do it karana Allah. It we call it what? Ikhlas. Shara, amalan, mustajab with Allah. Number one, ikhlas. Number two, wahuwa muhsin. Amalan tu mesti mari daripada Al-Quran dan As-Sunnah. Muhsin, ihsan. It's not any amalan, I give people to eat something which is haram. To, I give something from the Quran. Is with the Sharia. Something that is in the Sharia can be used. So your amalan ada dua rukun to be accepted. Ikhlas, and this amal you do is something from the Quran, and you cannot take people come we jog it karena Allah, come we go to belly dancing karena Allah, come we believe mind Judy karena Allah. You cannot. The amalan must be ikhlas and must be from the Quran and the Sunnah, then it is accepted. Okay, and then Allah said, these are the people, lahu ajruhu inda rabbih. The bahla is waiting there with Allah. Wala khawfun alayhim, wala hum yahzanun. Tak takut, teka orang lain takut. Tak sedih, teka orang lain sedih. Because you are filthy rich. Hari kiamat. Your amalan all there waiting for you. very rich yearbook, a very steady run line guitar, run line takut. You are not scared. Your timban is very heavy. You have a lot of amalan in your book. And then Allah said, Yahudi Nasrani ni bleh bleh nala. It's not only with Muslims, even among them. Yahudi kata Nasrani jahat. Nasrani kata Yahudi jahat. وقالت اليهود ليست النصارى على شيء وقالت النصارى ليست اليهود على شيء وهم يتلون الكتاب بدح المريكة مسن هذا كتاب كذلك قال الذين لا يعلمون مثل قولهم إن له سكاب أوران ينتقد علمه أوران ينتقد علمه macam ni lah. Kalau mereka berilmu, mereka guna ilmu yang ada tu, they will never talk like that. Tashabahat qala alladhina la ya'lamuna mithla qawlihim. Serupa juga musyrikin Quraisy lah lebih kurang. Duduk kata Muhammad tak betul. Nasrani kata Yahudi tak betul. Yahudi kata Nasrani tak betul. Sama lah buat-buat ni Allah said. Anyhow, فالله يحكم بينهم يوم القيامة فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون. Leave it to Allah. Allah will do the hukum hari kiamat. Mereka ikhtilaf. Ini kata ini tak betul. Itu kata ini tak betul. Musyrikin Quraisy pun kata tak betul Nabi Muhammad, tak betul. So, because they refuse to accept the haqiqa, and because of this, leave it to Allah. Allah will do the hukum har kiamat. And then Allah said, the worst people, this is Allah, orang yang buat khianat ke masjid. Especially that time, Rasulullah nak pergi Masjidul Haram, they refused to let him go in. Mas Sabran Hudaybiyah. So Allah said, the worst people, this is Allah, orang yang stop people to go to masjid. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ أَنْ يُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ. Tak bagi orang masuk salat dalam masjid. Dan apa lagi? وَسَعَى فِي خَرَابِهَا وَأْخِيَنَا pula ke masjid. And this happened, the Christian, the Yahudi, try to buat, the Christian try to buat khianat ke Baitul Maqdis, buang sampah, buang kotor, and the musyrikin Quraysh don't allow Rasulullah to go to Masjid Al-Haram. So this ayat turun because of them. Allah said, the worst people, this is Allah yang habis aniaya kadiri. Siapa? Yang buat kharab atau buat merusakkan Baitullah atau tak bagi orang masuk Baitullah. These are the worst people. And Allah said, because of this, nantilah. One day, ma kana lahum an yadkhuluha illa khaifi. One day, I promise, they will never be allowed to go there. They are takut to go there, which is happening now. All the kawasan of Jaziratul Arab, Makkah, Madinah, all the mushrikeen, kafirin cannot go there. Allah said, one day, what they have done to Muhammad ni, I one day with the undan of Rasulullah, make all the Yahudi out of Madinah, all the kafirin out of Makkah. True enough now, no kafir can go to Makkah, no kafir can go to Madinah, sampai hari kiamat. Allah said, ma kana lakum an yadkhulu. And it was a good news to Rasulullah SAW that what, sooner or later, these people will not be allowed to be in Makkah or in Madinah. And Allah said, what? Orang yang buat khianat di Baitullah, tak bagi orang masuk sembahyang di Baitullah, lahum khizyun fid dunya, wa lahum fil akhirati azabun azim. Siksa yang amat berat dunia akhirat. Orang yang cuba, and this is an undan-undan yang umum. Maybe zaman Rasulullah zaman, sampai sekarang ni, the worst people di sisi Allah, orang yang tak bagi orang pergi masjid, atau buat khianat ke masjid, buat sambah, buat. Even there is a lot we have to respect. Even Rasulullah SAW said what? If you see people suara tinggi di masjid, you must marah dengan mereka. Don't raise your voice in the mosque. If you see people meniaga di masjid, you must stand up and say, "Binas salam meniaga you." If they do jual in the mosque, because this is Baytullah, rumah Tuhan. That's why we have to respect the mosque. Cannot talk loudly, cannot quarrel, cannot. Some people even in the masjid don't nombak, don't cakap hal Quran dalam masjid. This is Baytullah, you know. So Allah said, anyone try to buat benda macam ni, khizyun fi dunya wa fil akhirati adabun azim. Dunya pun binasa, akhir. There is adab in the mosque, adab di Baytullah. Mesti masuk dengan hormat. Mesti kalau ada peluang, buatlah sunat tahiyatul masjid. Duduk dengan adab. Jangan buat, you know, suara tinggi. Because always remind yourself, you are what? I am in Baytullah. Even Rasulullah said what? Jannibu awladakum al-masajid. Jannibu majaninakum al-masajid. Minjawilah orang gila masuk masjid. Jangan allow orang gila masuk masjid. Jangan allow budak-budak masuk masjid. Budak-budak yang tak boleh control themselves. Kalau budak-budak 7 years, 8 years, okay lah, because we want to train them. Tapi budak 2 tahun, 3 tahun, dengan pampers, dengan najis dia, jalan sini, jalan situ, dengan makanan dia, should not actually.
Mana yang orang pergi
Makkah Madinah, exceptional. It's just people coming from very far, nowhere to keep. It's okay. That's why they make an special for anak-anak, special bar that you hear crying and all that. They don't allow them to go in front. And that's special, but that's why usually those who go in front too, curi-curi juga masuk lah. By right should not. And it is because this one, Baytullah, you cannot compare. Masjid al-Haram, you cannot compare with ordinary mosque. It's exceptional coming from far. So it's okay lah, it's allowed. We have to put the children. Nak pergi juga Baytullah, tak ada tempat. But of course lagi afdal, tak bawa lah. But Rasulullah in a hadith, he said, "Jannibu awladakum al-masajid. Jannibu majaninakum al-masajid." Don't allow budak-budak kecil-kecil to go to the mosque. Don't allow orang gila to go to the mosque. Because this is Baytullah. And here Allah said, orang yang tak hormat ke masjid atau buat khianat ke masjid. Of course, sebab nuzul ayat ni, Yahudi, Nasrani, Mushrikin. And Allah said, one day they cannot go in anymore. They will be scared to go in because people will catch them, which is already happened. And it was what a good news to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he knows before it happened that it will happen. And then Allah answering pula the Nasrani, the Christian, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا. Mereka duduk kata Tuhan mempunyai anak. Bal lahu ma fis samawati wal ardi kullun lahu qanitun. Semualah tunduk kepadanya. Semua milik dia. Subhanahu. Maha suci Allah. To have a child. To have anak. Lam yalid. Walam yulad. Walam yakun lahu kufuwan ahad. But orang Nasrani, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدَا سُبْحَانَهُ بَلْ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ كُلٌّ لَهُ قَانِتُونَ. Maha suci Allah, apa saja di langit, apa saja di bumi, milik dia, dan semua tunduk kepadanya. بَدِيعُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وإذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون. Allah yang cipta langit, Allah yang cipta bumi, dan Allah, anything He wanted to happen, He will say kun fayakun. Allah want to tell what? Isa came to Maryam dengan kun fayakun. Maryam became pregnant in Isa dengan kun fayakun. Allah can do anything. Kita bangun daripada kubur dengan kun fayakun. That's why Yasin all about إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا. Kita sudah jadi debu, kita sudah tulang hancur, kita sudah jadi sama rata dengan bumi. Tapi Allah kata kun, bangun balik semua. So Allah said, I can do anything dengan kun fayakun. Okay? So this one was the answer to Christian that say Allah min bunyai ana. Allah now nak hibur Nabi Muhammad punya hati, because he is facing a lot of challenge. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Yahudi lagi, Nasrani lagi, musyrikin, kafirin lagi. So Allah said like this lah, wahai Muhammad, inna arsalnaka bil haqq bashiran wa nadhira. Your work, your tugas, you are rasul bil haqq. Itu kebenaran. You are a rasul. Don't worry. وَلَا تُسْأَلْ عَنْ أَصْحَابِ الْجَحِيمِ. وَلَا تُسْأَلُ عَنْ أَصْحَابِ. I will never ask you why these people terlepas and become ahli neraka. It's not your job. Hidayah mari daripada Allah. Allah bagi kepada siapa yang dia hendaki. So don't worry. Your own uncles ka, your own cousins ka, your own friends ka, tak mau jadi Muslim, it's not your job. You are just a preacher. You preach, people listen, alhamdulillah. People don't listen, I will not ask you. It's not your problem. Okay? And of course, Allah give him warning. But be careful. وَلَنْ تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَنْ نَصَارَ حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. In spite of all of this, maybe Yahudi Nasrani will are not happy with you unless you follow them. And they will try their best that you follow them. Don't. Be careful. قُلْ جَوَابْ لَهْكَ مَرِكَ. If they ask you, become la like us, follow la us, ya Muhammad, you must bandai jawab. إِنَّ هُدَى اللَّهِ هُوَ الْهُدَى. Allah bagi hidayah kepada siapa yang dia hendaki. You tak dapat hidayah, it's not my problem. I have done my work, I preach you people. You tak dapat hidayah, it's not my problem. Then be careful ya Muhammad. وَلَئِنِ اتَّبَعْتَ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ بَعْدَ الَّذِي جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ. If you try to follow them, after all what I give you, the ilmu, I'm not your friend lah. I will not help you. You understand? Maknanya Allah said, that doesn't mean they will not try. Even so, you are not responsible. I know some terlepas jadi ashabul jahim because you are just a preacher. So some of them will try their best. Don't try to follow them. Tell them innal huda huda Allah. Allah give hidayah kepada siapa yang dia hendaki. You tak dapat hidayah, it's up to you lah people. But never follow them. If you try to follow them, why Muhammad, I am not going to help you anymore because I have given you enough warning. Sometimes Rasulullah need these doses of semangat. Otherwise, they are human facing a lot of challenge. So Allah want him to what? Istiqamah. So Allah said what? Don't try to follow. You follow after all this. مَا لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ. I will not be helping you anymore. Understand?